Good morning to you at home, and welcome to MSNBC's live coverage on this Monday, July 4th. I'm Erin O'Hearn. We begin with the latest from the January 6th investigation into the attack on the Capitol. The hearings are on pause until later this month, but the committee is not letting up as members fanned out across the Sunday shows this holiday weekend. From talk of new evidence to possible new witnesses, we are covering all angles this morning. First, the possibility that former President Donald Trump could be referred to the Justice Department for criminal prosecution. Here's an interview with the vice chair of the committee, Congresswoman Liz Cheney. Still ahead, how long to get from New York to Orlando? 3-4 hours? Nope. For some travelers, that's 45 hours. It's just one of the nightmare scenarios playing out at packed airports coast to coast. We'll go live to Los Angeles next on Morning Joe. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Airlines have delayed nearly 15,000 flights so far over the holiday weekend and canceled more than 1,500 others. That is according to new data obtained by the flight tracking website FlightAware. Up next.
We have to talk about how police attack sometimes. Not all the time, not all police, but they do attack. And in this case, there was an attack on my client. That was an attack.
And that was Bobby DiCello on MSNBC earlier this morning. He is the attorney for the family of Jaylen Walker, who was killed in a hail of bullets last week, minutes after police in Ohio say he fled a traffic stop. We'll talk more about this case straight ahead. Anger is mounting in Akron, Ohio, after police there released new body cam video of the moments eight officers fatally opened fire on one man. Millions, including I'm sure many of you watching right now, prepare to head to the beach to spend their holiday. But shark patrols are in place and they're up in the East Coast after a recent series of sightings and attacks. This is not something I like to report. NBC's Kerry Sanders joins us next with what you need to know before you step into the water on this July 4th. On this 4th of July holiday, millions of Americans across the country will be hitting the beach. But after a recent series of shark attacks and sightings, lifeguards and first responders are on alert. NBC's Kerry Sanders has more from Florida. Kerry. Well, still ahead is a third time the charm. There's actually talk of impeaching Donald Trump again. That idea is not getting much traction on Capitol Hill, but the committee investigating the attack on the Capitol has other cards to play, and we'll talk about those, what they are, coming up. Now to a community in mourning after a driver died while performing a stunt during a Michigan air show. NBC News correspondent Priscilla Thompson has the details. And our thanks to NBC's Priscilla Thompson for that report. Still ahead, much more on the politics surrounding the January 6th investigation. We'll explain what has Democrats divided. And a major public figure in Uvalde, Texas, finally resigns a month and a half after the shooting at Robb Elementary School that killed 19 students and two teachers. Plus, if you thought presidential Twitter feuds would end when the former President Trump was kicked out of the platform, well, you would be wrong. We'll tell you about the back and forth between the White House and billionaire Jeff Bezos. We're back in just a moment.
Can the Republican Party survive in the way you've known it if Donald Trump is again chosen?
It can't survive if he's our nominee.
No.
No. I think that he can't be the party nominee, and I don't think the party would survive that. I believe in the party, and I believe in what the party can be and what the party can stand for, and I'm not ready to give that up. Those of us who believe in Republican principles and ideals have a responsibility to try to lead the party back to what it can be.
Powerful words from Republican Congresswoman Liz Cheney on the future of the GOP. The January 6th hearings may be on hiatus, but the committee is still making news. Cheney says there's a chance the committee could make multiple multiple criminal referrals of Donald Trump to the Justice Department. We've also learned the next hearing set for later this month will focus on the mob at the Capitol, including who organized it and who financed it. Good morning and welcome to MSNBC's live coverage on this Monday, July 4th. I'm Erin O'Hearn. Coming up.
There's compelling evidence that the law enforcement response to the attack at Robb Elementary was an abject failure and antithetical to everything we've learned over the last two decades since the Columbine massacre.
Strong words from the director of the Texas Department of Public Safety last month, hammering the police response to the mass shooting at Robb Elementary. Today, there's a big update from Uvalde, and we'll bring you the details next. Stay with us. In just a few hours, many of you will be lighting up that grill. And hot dogs, of course, are a staple on July 4th. But this year, some Americans might need to eat them without the bun. Up next, as we celebrate Independence Day, by some measures, American pride is at an all-time low. We'll dig into the numbers with Gallup's editor-in-chief. There is new polling this morning that shows a record low number of adults say they're, quote, extremely proud to be an American. In the latest Gallup survey, just 38% expressed the highest level of pride for being a U.S. citizen. That number has been steadily declining since it reached a record high of 70% back in 2003. Up next, after more than a month on the run, a fugitive who allegedly killed a woman she saw as a romantic rival is now behind bars. The details of that story is next. After 43 days on the run, a fugitive yoga teacher accused of killing a romantic rival is now under arrest. NBC News correspondent Rima Ellis has more. And that does it for me for this morning. Happy 4th of July. MSNBC's live coverage continues after a quick break.